Hello and welcome to the Sichuan Water Sports School, the venue for the rowing regatta at the World University Games. The Sichuan Water Sports School, the clubhouse of which we're seeing here, is a man-made waterway located next to the Jin River, which has naturally irrigated these verdant surroundings for thousands of years. Now time for the first medal contest in this rowing regatta, the mixed quadruple sculls A final. Now, Czechia, Australia, Poland, Germany, Italy, and the People's Republic of China all represented. There is the German hull, number four, trying to keep pace with Poland and also trying to keep ahead of Czechia in the boat on the far side. But still, it's Poland. Katian Szezewik is the stroke. Jakub Wozniak, Katarina Duda, and Barbara Strang is in the bow seat. Here's the Czech four. We'll see Anna Strancikova in the sculls final. She's one of the top contenders in the single sculls, and she goes in seat number two. Poland have led from the very start here, as we come into the final 500 meters, where the stroke weight will need and be asked to be upped by Jackson Free for Australia in the stroke seat, by Katian Szezewik in the Poland stroke, and Brenker in the German stroke. And Germany and Poland are looking to fight this out to be the top two here. And the Italians, Borghi, Corazza, Borgonova and Tonelli, they may all be in contest later on, but they're not going to hold back now. They can sense that there's an opportunity here. The Italians moving on up on Poland. And it's Italy who are emerging as the chief contender to the Polish here. A young Italian quartet. Italy have comfortably brought the strongest squad here to Chengdu across all the boat classes, and they might be able to get their first gold medal at the very first time of asking. But Poland desperately holding on. They've got to not just keep the stroke rate high, but keep the smoothness as well, and the stability in these boats becomes all important. They're all new boats for European crews. They've not rowed in them before. It's been a significant tune-up period to get that stability and the smoothness through the water, and Poland are still keeping that smoothness and keeping their advantage, and Italy are pushing and pushing, but the Polish are going to hold on for gold in the mixed quadruple sculls. The first medal in the regatta decided. It goes to Poland from Italy, from Germany. Czechia coming in for fourth. But that Polish effort and that grit and determination to hold on and see off a rising Italian challenge has given Poland the gold medal. 6:18. The medalists in the mixed quadruple sculls. The gold medal won by Poland, the silver medal won by Italy, and the bronze medal won by Germany. The men's pair A final. Czechia, Italy, the Netherlands, China, Moldova, and Turkey. The second gold medal contest of the day gets underway. The men's pair final. Fastest qualifiers are the Dutch in lane number three. China in the lead. Republic of Moldova just about holding on to second over the Netherlands. And then it's Italy and Turkey vying for fourth position at present. Czechia are in last, and in lane one, perhaps out of the running. China looking strong. The Dutch now up to second. Moldova in third. The Chinese with 200 and 300 or so. Well ahead of them before they get into that final 200 sprint. They go past the final 500 meter mark in a good position. But here come Van Veen and Brewer, encroaching on that lead for the Chinese, increasing the stroke rate. Half a boat length behind now. Moldova just about staying in touch. Italy and Turkey are looking to come up on them and challenge for that bronze medal. But the goal to be fought out between the Netherlands and the People's Republic of China. Ni Zhulin and Zhong Songhu finding themselves under pressure now. With the fast-moving Dutch moat of Van Veen and Brewer encroaching in on that lead. And it's down just to half a canvas. And the grimace on the face of the bowman Ni Zhulin as Zhong Songhu tries to raise the stroke rate. Moldova in their own battle for third. But for the gold medal, it is still just about in Chinese hands. The Netherlands are as close as they've been all race, and they're timing it well. Less than 100 to go, less than 50 meters to go. The Netherlands now just about ahead of China. The Dutch, the fastest qualifiers, have timed it well to cross the line just ahead of China and take the gold in the men's pairs. What a win for Utrecht University as well, with Van Veen and Brewer with a time of 6 minutes 30. Peter Van Veen of the Netherlands with his partner Elliot Brewer from the People's Republic of China, Ni Zhulin and Zhong Songhu, and from the Republic of Moldova, Alexander Bulat and Alexandru Maznic. The USA, Italy, China, the Netherlands and Germany. 3/10 of a second the difference at the last time check, but the Chinese making that up now, and they'll hit the front for the first time quite shortly. And Germany now in second position, dropping down against the Chinese, but a canvas behind. Sane Mugen and Via Ruta in third position for the Netherlands. Coming up to the final 500 meters. China from Germany, from the Netherlands, and then Italy's Irene Cravero and Chiara Benvenuti. 2 seconds the gap for the Chinese. China over Germany, over the Netherlands. And Sane Mugen and Via Ruta are looking to challenge the Germans now for second position. China with a boat's length in the lead. They start slowly, but then they build. Coming towards the final 250 meter mark. First gold medal of the rowing regatta for the Chinese is within sight. Germany looking to find something else here. The Dutch look like they won't have anything left to challenge the Chinese, as Zhou Yuji and Jung Pexin of the Wuhan Sports University look to bring this home for the People's Republic of China. 100 meters remaining. China from the Netherlands, from Germany, Italy after that. And China will bring this home now. It's gold in the women's pair for the People's Republic of China. Silver for the Dutch, and Germany hold on to the bronze. Italy pushing hard for the fourth, but not quite hauling in the Germans. Zhou Yuji and Jung Pexin give us a glimpse of the future in Chinese rowing. Now we move to the women's single sculls A final. Italy, Lithuania, South Africa and Czechia in the center lanes, China and the Netherlands competing. Courtney Wesley who leads. Santrakova in lane four has actually gone past Wesley. Well, this will give us a better idea of things. with 500 metres to go. It is Santrakova who's overhauled Wesley, and Wesley now struggling to hold off Sun Hong Jing. Czechia from South Africa, from the People's Republic of China, and then Marte Dahmen of the Netherlands is in fourth. But what a turnaround we might be seeing here from Anna Santrakova. 30 seconds behind Courtney Wesley 2 weeks ago in Bulgaria at the Under 23 World Championships. This is some return to form here at Chengdu. Wesley more than half a boat's length behind. Has Santrakova judged that correctly? And judged her energy reserves too. The drone shot provides the best accurate picture of how far ahead she is. Wesley is still within touching distance, however. It's Santrakova in the centre, Wesley to her left. Then on the right, China's Sun Hong Jing. But Santrakova is going to head towards the line here, and she will hold off the South African for the golds. Czechia, number one. South Africa in second, and China in third. The Dutch and Marte Dahmen crossing in fourth position. A return to the top of the podium for Anna Santrakova after the disappointments of the Under 23 World Championships in Bulgaria. Courtney Wesley with the silver medal, and Sun Hong Jing with another medal for the Chinese. The men's single sculls final is underway. In lane one, the Netherlands on the far side with Jaap Schenk. They're in lane one, Poland in lane two with Cesare Litka. In lane three, Azerbaijan's Barman Nasiri. Italy is in lane four with Riccardo Peretti. Lane five sees China's Chen Weichun, and Lithuania's Povilas Stankonas is in lane number six. Cesare Litka is moving up to second position for Poland in lane number two, following China's lead in lane number five. Good shot of the surroundings to the Sichuan Water Sports School. Here's a man-made waterway, of course. We are right by the Jin River. A stunning location for these World University Games. Barman Nasiri here. He was second fastest in the heats. And then in the semi-final, he didn't quite match the speed he did in the first race of his regatta. But here he is, trying to move on up as best he can. So the lead at the moment from Chen Weichun of the People's Republic of China. Barman Nasiri almost 2 seconds behind the Chinese rower. Italy's Riccardo Peretti has really dropped back now. And Poland's Cesare Litka in third position. Nasiri level pegging now with Chen Weichun. The Azerbaijani rower is hitting his smooth rate and pulling ahead of Chen. Barman Nasiri trying to find that stroke rate in the mid to possibly higher 30s. Can anyone throw themselves back into contention? 3 seconds, 0.29, the gap from Nasiri to Litka in second place. Chen Weichun, the early leader, starting to drop back a bit. Nasiri will be aiming to go far faster than he's managed in his heat and his semi-final. Lane number six as well, the Lithuanian Povilas Stankonas is going really well. He's overhauled Chen Weichun now, and he might be able to do the same to Cesare Litka on the far side. And Stankonas is looking very good. The Lithuanian is hitting a high stroke rate as we come into the last 150 metres. Litka is making a comeback as well. Chen Weichun is having to grapple with second and third position as best he can, and Litka has gone. Litka's lost momentum. The pole is out of it. It's now a three-way race, and Stankonas, Povilas Stankonas from Lithuania, will take this on the line. Gold for Lithuania. And Chen Weichun's comeback only results in third. Barman Nasiri, the leader for so much of this race, well, he couldn't hold off the flying Lithuanian, Povilas Stankonas. From Lithuania, Povilas Stankonas with the gold medal. From the People's Republic of China, Chen Weichun with the silver medal. And from Azerbaijan, Bahman Nasiri with the bronze medal. The lightweight women's single sculls A final is next. The lane order: Japan, Czechia, Poland, the Netherlands, Germany and Italy. And we are underway, all six lanes filled. For the Dutch, in lane four is Elizabeth Krujens. For Poland, in lane three, Zuzanna Jasinska. She's the fastest qualifier over two heats. She's from the Wrocław University of Science and Technology. She's got the lead over Kurenches by a canvas, and then Kurenches is ahead of Tertunt of Germany. But Italy's Elena Sali, well, she's one to watch out for as well in lane six. Fourth fastest qualifier. Stopping the clock at 8:20 in her heat. At the halfway mark, Jasinska showing her class. And she does have a track record of quality. She's an Olympic finalist in double sculls from Tokyo, no less. She made that final with Katarzyna Velina. They finished well down on the eventual winners, Emily Craig and Imogen Grant of Great Britain. But it was nonetheless a very good showing from the then 20-year-old. But she's still at university. And the age limit at these World University Games has been stretched to 27 to accommodate for the postponement, so that no athletes who could have competed in Chengdu in 2021, when they were originally slated to, miss out. But that's not a problem for Jasinska anyway. And at the moment, the opposition aren't looking like a problem for Jasinska. So Jasinska, 5 seconds ahead of Sali, who's a second on Tertunt. ...400 meters left remaining, a little bit less than that. And Zuzanna Jasinska blowing away this field in the lightweight women's single sculls. Elena Sali has edged out a little bit more water on Julia Tertunt, but no one will catch these three medals, undoubtedly coming from the current leaders. Sali putting in a lot of work to try and keep her silver medal, and that's really where the contest will lie. Jasinska is going to close this out comfortably. The favourite pre-race and the favourite from about 500 metres onwards. A fine race for Poland. Gold for Jasinska, silver comes for Elena Sali of Italy, and the bronze to Julia Tertunt of Germany. Second gold of the regatta for Poland, and this one in a singles boat class. And another silver for Italy as well, who add to that tally of theirs. And the bronze to Germany's Julia Tertunt. The lightweight men's single sculls final. The Netherlands, Germany, Turkey, the Islamic Republic of Iran, the People's Republic of China and Austria. So at the halfway mark, it is Tang for China. From Gok, from Turkey, then Mahmoud Pur, Kabash and Zeno Robertson are all of a level. Still out in front with Tang. Half a boat length, his advantage. Gok is moving up nicely. Man who won his heat and his semi-final, even if he wasn't the fastest timed rower in the contest. This men's single sculls lightweight category is starting to brim with promise for a tight finish. Tang looking to try and keep that advantage, but it's being reduced to a canvas now. Tang's margin of leading over Gok ever reducing. And the effort being worn on his face ever more. Still, it is the Chinese rower from Mahmudpur and Enish Gok. Mahmudpur moving to the front of the race for the first time. Look at the bow from lane four, edging ahead now. Amir Hussain Mahmudpur at the 1500 meter mark hits the front. He has the lead from Tang. Tang and then Enish Gok. Zeno Robertson is in fourth behind with Sebastian Kabash. And then it's Brian Poll of the Netherlands, currently bringing up the rear. Less than a second between the leading trio, but that might be changing soon as Mahmudpur is stretching. Turkey's Enish Gok looks to go with him and just stay and hang in there. Coming on for 300 metres remaining in the lightweight men's single sculls. Amir Hussain Mahmudpur has almost a full length on Enish Gok. But Mahmudpur and Gok, the two fastest qualifiers, now stretching Hai Chi Tang. And will it be a fight between just the leading two now for the gold medal? Kabash can't stay with the front three, that's for certain. So the Austrian is out of the running. Tang from China is really just looking for the bronze medal, and in case anyone else has a mistake, he might sweep up the silver. But for the gold, Amir Hussain Mahmudpur and Enish Gok are the contenders. Mahmudpur in front. He can't get that lead out to any further, however. And Mahmudpur is being closed down now a bit by Enish Gok inside the final 100 metres. Gok is coming hard. And Gok and Mahmudpur locked in a duel for the gold medal. Gok is the faster at the moment. Can Mahmudpur hold on? It's going to be Turkiye with the gold. Enish Gok takes it on the line. Amir Hussain Mahmudpur lies back, hunches himself forward as Tang crosses the line. What a race. In the lightweight men's single sculls, the gold medal went to Turkiye's Enish Gok. The silver medal to the Islamic Republic of Iran's Amir Hussain Mahmudpur. And the bronze medal to the People's Republic of China, Tang Haichi.